a southern style shopping list. Got my notebook here. Open it up. I'm gonna start writing down everything that I need. I'm probably gonna be making a pecan pie, my favorite. A chocolate pecan pie. Maybe a buttermilk pie. It's one of my favorites also. And I do like fruit pies, but not as much as a pecan or some kind of chocolate meringue, chocolate pecan. Those are my favorites. So I'm gonna have to write down all the ingredients, make sure I have them all before I start baking the pies. And I'm gonna start out with the pie shells. Either I can buy a few already made just for backup, but I like to make my own pie crust. So I need plenty of flour. I'm gonna get about 5 pounds of flour at least. So I put that down, 5 pounds of flour. And then you can't make a good pie crust without butter, real butter. So I'm probably gonna get about, I'm gonna say about 5 pounds of butter, because I don't know how many pies I'm gonna make, and I like the most amount of butter I can put in my pie crust without overdoing it, because real butter makes the pie crust, really does. So 5 pounds of butter. It's gonna be unsalted butter, because you can add salt to your recipe if you need it. But if you're baking, a lot of times you use unsalted butter. Okay, so we're gonna do that. And then I do have some salt, but I might buy one more container because I'm probably gonna run out in the next, probably by Christmas. So salt. And I've got baking powder. Usually don't use a whole lot of baking powder. You can use the whole can for pretty much 6 months, depending on how much you bake. If you're baking a lot of biscuits, you might go through baking powder a lot. But I think I have enough baking powder. And I'm gonna need a lot of eggs. A lot. Probably about 2 dozen eggs. Okay. Write down my 2 dozen eggs. You want fresh eggs. Always get fresh eggs. And then pecans. Now, pecans are expensive. Even down here in Texas, they're about $10 a pound if you want premium pecans. And you can get the bits for a little bit cheaper, but if you want the whole pecans, it's gonna be about $10 a pound going around there. So I'm gonna say I'm probably gonna make about 4 pecan pies. So I might get about 5 pounds. That's a lot. But I'm also gonna make a chocolate pecan pie, which is the best pie in the world. Chocolate pecan pie. Okay, so I'm gonna write down pecans. And well, to go with my chocolate pecan pie, I use dark chocolate, which is the best. It's the absolute best. And you probably need about 70% dark chocolate. That makes the best. It's a little bitter, but you can also sweeten it up. It depends on how much sugar you put into it. So, I'm gonna say probably about 2 bars of dark chocolate, because I really won't use that much, because it doesn't take much to flavor it with the dark chocolate, because it's a bittersweet, kind of strong flavor. But once you add the sugar in, it's heavenly, heavenly. So I'm gonna put dark chocolate. And I've got enough pie pans. I use the glass pie pans, but I might buy a package of just the aluminum foil, just for, you never know. A lot of times I have excess pie. When I get in a pie making frenzy, then I might have a little excess batter left or filling, and I can fill those up with it and make an extra pie. So I'm going to put that aluminum pie plates. You know, the glass pie plates make the best, I think, for me. Sometimes the aluminum, the bottom gets a little overdone, so you have to be very careful. You gotta watch them when you cook them in the aluminum pie plates. So, to me, I use the glass ones. They're the best. Sometimes the ceramic ones are good. Those are good, too. Okay, so we've got the flour, the butter, the salt, the eggs, the pecans, and, of course, the dark chocolate. Can't do without that. Some extra pie plates. Now, if I want to make a meringue, you have to use cream of tartar with that. I still have some left over from last year, and I think it's still good. You can usually use it for a couple of years. So I'm not going to get any of that. But you're going to have to use the egg whites to make the meringue. So I have to save some of the egg whites. And then I'll save the yolks. I can use those for making breakfast burritos. So far we've got a pretty good list. I know I'm missing something. I've got to think about I'm making a buttermilk pie. Buttermilk. Okay. I need buttermilk for the buttermilk pie. And heavy cream. Actually, heavy cream is the best. Heavy cream to use in any of your pies, buttermilk pie, pecan pie, any kind of thick, creamy pie, buttermilk, or maybe just a little bit of buttermilk. You don't want to overload the buttermilk because a lot of people don't make their pies with buttermilk anymore, but it does make really creamy, and it kind of has a tang to it, but heavy cream is one of the most important ingredients, and you can't forget that. So I've done heavy cream. That makes some of the most rich, delicious tasting pies ever. I can't wait. And if I decide to make some fruit pies, I'll probably make a cherry or maybe an apple. Sometimes I make a cinnamon apple where I mix the apple and the cinnamon, and it's so good. Cinnamon apple, and then you put sugar, a little cinnamon on top of the crust, and it tastes so good when it comes out. Oh my gosh, it's so good. But, when I make the cherry pies, I just use the canned, because it's too labor intensive to pit the cherries and then cook them down, especially if I'm making four or five other pies, pecan pies, a chocolate pecan. So, and a lot of times I don't make cherry pie because it's really easy. But if I've already made a lot of the others, fruit pies to me are the secondary pies. I like the pecan, of course, and then the chocolate pecan. That's probably my favorite, really, but it's so rich and so heavy on the calories. But, you know, who counts them on Thanksgiving? Who cares? Okay, cherries and apples. And I've got enough cinnamon. Usually don't use a whole thing of cinnamon throughout the year, so I still got a little canister of cinnamon. So, and, oh, sugar. Of course, we need sugar. Need a ton of sugar. Okay. Write down the sugar. And it'll probably take all day or half the day. I may have to start not even the night before. Like the first night before, depending on if I don't have to work the next day. Or maybe I might be making one or two in the morning, but some of them I have to let them sit. It's better to let them sit, make a pie, let it set for a while or overnight, the next day, it's set, it's gelled, and everything is so put together and it holds together really well. You can just slide it out of the pie plate real heavy, without it being too heavy, without it falling over. So that'll be one of the things I'll be having to do on the night before for sure. Pretty much most of the desserts, unless I decide to make some cookies, which I would probably make either chocolate chip or cinnamon, or not cinnamon, sugar cookies. And you can put cinnamon on top of the sugar cookies, that's really good too. So that's probably why I had that on my brain, the cinnamon. Okay, so I'm gonna write down each pie so I don't forget what I'm making. Pecan, number one. Chocolate pecan, it's probably one of my favorites. Then a buttermilk, and then buttermilk. If y'all don't know what buttermilk pie is, it's kind of like a chess pie, but it's a little bit more, I think it's got more flavor, and it's a little, maybe a tad more creamier or tangy, just a little bit. It's so good. Buttermilk pie is the best. Okay, pecan, chocolate pecan, buttermilk, and then a cherry, and apple cinnamon, or cinnamon apple, whichever way you want to say it, either way. Those are so good. And for cookies, I said, if I have time, the chocolate chip, which is my favorite actually, and then maybe some sugar cookies. So we've got it all written out, all my ingredients, and then all the different pies, and then the chocolate chip and the sugar cookies. So that's gonna be my shopping list. That's for Southern style for a Thanksgiving, a Southern, or either Texan type of Texas Southern style Thanksgiving dessert. Those are some of the best desserts. Thanksgiving desserts are just one of my favorite things.